हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू द इंग्लिश क्लास स्टैंडर्ड 10. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अ पोएम नंबर 3 फ्रॉम द फर्स्ट फ्लाइट बुक, अ टाइगर इन द जू, रिटन बाय लेस्ली नॉरिस. स्टूडेंट्स, लेट मी टेल यू अबाउट द राइटर लेस्ली नॉरिस. लेस्ली नॉरिस इज अ प्राइज विनिंग वेल्श पोएट एंड अ शॉर्ट स्टोरी राइटर एज वेल. He also taught at academic institutions at Britain and United States. Okay? In this poem, Leslie Norris has displayed the life of the tiger who is at present kept in the cage, kept in the zoo, who is confined in the cage. And then Leslie Norris compares his life, the tiger's life, how he's spending in the forest. That contrast, that difference is mentioned, is displayed in this poem. So you can say that this poem is about the tiger who is confined in the cage. Okay? So aaj hum aise poem, aise tiger ke bare mein padhenge jo ki abhi ek pinjre mein band hai, ek zoo mein. Students, this poem is very short poem, sweet poem. There are total 5 stanzas and 4 lines each. Okay. Here, we go with the first stanza. That is, I am just reading out the lines. Students, please concentrate on the words and the word meanings. He stalks in his vivid stripes, the few steps of his cage. On pads of velvet quiet in his quiet rage. Very first, we will see the spellings, meanings. We will see the meanings of it. Stalk. Stalks means follow. Stalks means follow. Follow means what? Here, he stalks in his vivid stripes the few steps of his cage. Okay, stalks means follows. Vivid means having deep bright colors. Stripes you can see on the body of the tiger. You can see the strips on his body. First, we will see about the word meanings. Okay. Stalk means follows. Vivid means bright color. Stripes, you can see the stripes on his body. Okay, so here you have seen the tiger. The tiger is having orangish color, yellowish orangish color, a color along with the black stripes on his body. Okay, so here it is said that he stalks in his vivid stripe means the tiger is having vivid stripes, very beautiful, bright, very deep, bright colors stripe on his body. And he is able to walk a very few steps of his cage. Because as he is confined in the cage, he is not able to move any longer, any further. He could able to walk a few steps. Okay. On the pads of velvet quiet in his quiet rage. How he is walking? Whenever he is walking in the cage, one could not hear the sound of his pads. Why? Because his pads are like a velvet quiet. Velvet quiet means what? You can see the picture of velvet. Okay, here velvet is the picture. Of the velvet is the kind of cloth which is very soft, delicate, and the smooth texture. Okay, and similarly here the pads of the tiger has been compared with the texture of a velvet. Okay, so as his pads means what? Pads are the bottom. Okay, you can see the feet. The base of the feet, the base of the paws. So here, pads, that means paws of the tiger. And the paws of the tiger is very spongy. And whenever the tiger is walking in his cage, we could not listen to the sound of his feet. And in his quiet rage, that means the tiger is confined, and that's why he is so angry. But he could not display his anger because he knows that his anger, showing his anger, is useless, because no one is going to consider his anger anymore. And that's why he remained quiet. That means calm. ओके तो यहाँ पे कहा गया है फर्स्ट आंसर में कि एक टाइगर है जो कि अपने बॉडी पे काफ़ी विविड ब्राइट कलर की स्ट्राइप्स है उसके बॉडी के ऊपर, जो अपने पिंजरे में बंद है और कुछ कदम ही वो चल पाता है, लेकिन जब भी वो चलता है तब उसके कदमों की, उसके पैड्स की आवाज़ कुछ सुनाई नहीं आती, बहुत ही क्वाइट है. एंड दो ही बिकॉज ही इज़ कन्फाइंड इन द केज, दैट्स वाई उसको गुस्सा है, लेकिन वो गुस्सा किसी को दिखा नहीं पाता. एंड दैट्स वाई ही इज़ रिमेनिंग क्वाइट, ही इज़ रिमेनिंग काम. ओके सो हियर वी हैव सीन द फर्स्ट आंसर. द फर्स्ट आंसर इज डिस्प्लेइंग द लाइफ ऑफ द टाइगर इन द जू. मूविंग ऑन द सेकेंड स्टांजा, इन द सेकेंड स्टांजा वी विल लर्न अबाउट द लाइफ इन हिज जंगल. ओके नाउ नॉरिस इज सेइंग दैट हाउ अ टाइगर शुड बी. In the first stanza, he has shown us that the tiger is living in the cage and he is just able to move a few steps in the cage and he is angry, but he could not show his anger. Now in the second stanza, Norris is telling how the tiger should be. Tiger ko kaisa hona chahiye? Okay, he is saying that tiger means he should be snarling around houses at the jungle's edge, baring his white fangs, his claws, terrorizing the village. How he should be? Norris is saying that the very first we will see the meanings. We will see the meaning. What is snarl? Snarl means make an angry warning sound, roar. In that sense, we can say that roaring, ek dahalna, okay, angry sound nikalna, that is snarl. Okay, and bearing means exposing, to display, uncover, bearing. And third is fangs. What are fangs? Fangs are large sharp tooth, especially a canine tooth of a dog or wolf. Okay, so fangs here the sharp tooth, especially a canine tooth. Okay, now what does the poet want to say? That a tiger should snarl around the houses at the jungle's edge. You know that at the jungle's edge, jungle ke kinare pe, jungle jahan pe boundary khatam ho jati hai, the jungle's edge pe there are houses, there are villages, and villagers are living in that village. Many houses are located at the border of the jungle. And whenever the writer is saying that whenever tiger entered the village, he snarl around the houses, and that's why the people are getting terrorized, the village is getting terrorized. Pure village ko, gaon walon ko dar lagne lagta hai ki jab bhi wo sher ki aawaz sunte, whenever they listen to the roar of the tiger, whenever they listen to the snarling sound of the tiger, they become terrorized, वो डर जाते हैं. तो यही नॉरिस कहना चाहते हैं कि टाइगर को कैसा होना चाहिए. टाइगर जो जंगल के आसपास जो गांव है वहां जाके उसने दहाड़ना चाहिए ताकि लोग उससे डरे. एंड अलॉन्ग विद द स्नार्लिंग एक्टिविटी ही शुड अनकवर हिज व्हाइट फैंग्स, दैट मीन्स व्हाइट कैनाइंस एंड हिज क्लॉज. ओके तो अपना जो विद्रूप एकदम भयानक रूप है वो भी उसको गांव वालों को दिखाना चाहिए ताकि जो टेरर है गांव में उसका बरकरार रहे, जो दहशत है गांव में उसकी बरकरार रहे. सो दैट इन दिस वे अ टाइगर शुड बी, दिस इज द ओपिनियन ऑफ द पोएट नॉरिस. ओके इन सेकंड स्टैंजा वी हैव सीन दैट हाउ द टाइगर शुड बी. अ टाइगर शुड बी snarling around the houses which are located at the jungle's border, jungle's edge, and tiger should uncover his white canines and his claws so that he could terror the villages. Okay, so next stanza, third one stanza, we will see what happened next. He should be lurking in shadows, sliding through long grass, near the water hole where plum deer pass. Again, Norris is saying that how a tiger should be. Tiger should be lurking in the shadow. What is lurking? Lurking means hidden, so as to wait in ambush. Okay, so lurking, that means, you know, that whenever tiger is attacking on his prey, whenever tiger attacking on his prey, directly he didn't attack. He just first hide himself in the long grass and slightly go near his prey, and then he attacks. Okay, so similarly यहाँ पे नॉरिस कहते हैं कि एक टाइगर को कैसा होना चाहिए. टाइगर should hidden himself in the shadow. एक शेडो में उसको छिपना चाहिए. स्लाइडिंग थ्रू लॉन्ग ग्रास में स्लाइड का मतलब ऐसे रेंगते हुए जाना चाहिए. कहाँ तक? वाटर होल तक जाना चाहिए. व्हाट इज वाटर होल? वाटर होल इज अ जस्ट वी कैन से दैट लिटिल वाटर बॉडी वेयर द एनिमल्स यूज टू कम टू ड्रिंक वाटर. एंड हियर विच एनिमल इज मेंशनड? हियर अलॉन्ग विद टाइगर वन मोर एनिमल इज मेंशनड, दैट इज डियर, जिसको हम हिंदी में हिरण कहते हैं. ओके, सो नियर दिस वाटर होल डियर्स आर यूज टू कम टू ड्रिंक वाटर. And that's why Norris is saying that a tiger should hide himself in the long grass, and then slightly sliding himself come to the water hole to catch his prey, to catch the deer, जो कि उसका फेवरेट शिकार होता है. डियर, हिरण उसका फेवरेट शिकार होता है. इसके लिए नॉरिस कहते हैं कि टाइगर को छिपना चाहिए और छिपकर हमला करना चाहिए. क्या, कहाँ पे? वाटर बॉडी के पास, वाटर के पास, जहाँ पे बाकी सारे एनिमल्स आते हैं, स्पेशली हिरण आते हैं. ठीक है, डियर आते हैं. सो इन दिस स्टांजा अगेन नॉरिस इज सेइंग द क्वालिटी. नॉरिस इज ऑल्सो सेइंग द नेचर, द फेरोशियस नेचर ऑफ द टाइगर. Similarly, the ferocious nature is explained in the next poem, which is now kept behind the bars. Okay, see students, here you can see the image of the tiger. Where he is confined in the cage, he is locked in the cage. Okay, and now as he locked in the cage, he himself locked his terrorizing nature, his ferocious nature. What the poet is trying to say in this stanza, but he is locked in a concrete cell, his strength behind bars, stalking the length of his cage, ignoring visitors. But he is locked in the concrete cell. Now you can see in the image that the tiger is locked in the concrete cell. You know, so concrete kya hota hai? What is concrete? Concrete is a mixture of broken stone or gravel, sand, cement and water, which can be sprayed or poured into molds and forms a mass resembling stone on hardening. Okay, this is a mixture which is, okay, the concrete is the mixture of stones or gravel, cement, sands and water, okay, which is used to construct the buildings, the bridges, the roads, okay, and institutions and many more. And once they're getting dry, it becomes hardened and more hardened. Similarly, in such a hard concrete cell, the tiger is locked. And the tiger, as I told you, tiger also himself locked his strength. उसकी जो ताकत है, उसका जो ferocious nature है, उसका जो terrorizing जो nature है, वो भी bars के पीछे बंद हो गया है. Bars, that means also cage. Cell, that is cage. Bars, that is cage. Cage, that is cage where the things are kept behind. Okay? Where in which the things are locked. Similarly, now Norris is saying that in the previous two stanzas, Norris has explained the life of tiger in the jungle, in the forest. But here in the stanza, Norris is saying that tiger is locked in the concrete cell where he also locked his strength behind the bars. And he is able to just walk to and fro in the cage, nothing else. And that's why he is ignoring, as he has locked his power, as he has locked his terrorizing nature, ferocious nature behind the bar, he could not display his anger, he could not roar on the visitors, and that's why he ignores the visitor. Okay, as he has locked his strength, he is ignoring the visitors. One more reason behind that, कि वो ignore क्यों करता है visitors को, क्योंकि उसको पता है, he knows very well कि मैं कितना भी गुस्सा करूँ, कितना भी चिड़ू, कितना भी roar करूँ, फिर भी visitors के ऊपर उसका कुछ असर नहीं होने वाला है. Here is nobody to take care of me, here is nobody to take care, to consider my roar, to consider my ferocious nature. Okay, so that is means to display, to discover, to display his ferocious nature is will be useless if nobody is going to consider you, and that's why tiger is ignoring the visitors. Okay, now in the last stanza, tiger's activity, final activity in the zoo, that is mentioned by the poet Norris. Norris says that he hears the last voice at night, the patrolling cars, and stares with his brilliant eyes at the brilliant stars. Okay, now this is the last activity done by the tiger in the zoo. Which activity? Norris is saying that in the zoo at the night, you know that almost in the evening only all the visitors, almost all the visitors left the zoo. Okay, and that's why the zoo becomes empty during the night, and there is no one except animals in the zoo. Now last activity of the tiger is mentioned in this stanza, that tiger is only able to hear the sound of the patrolling cars. What are patrolling cars? Meaning is given, patrolling cars are keeping watch over an area by regularly walking or traveling around it. स्टूडेंट्स यू नो दैट कि जब भी बहुत मतलब 12 बजे के बाद 11 12 बजे के बाद जब सारा सुनसान हो जाता है, द एरिया बिकम्स कम्प्लीटली साइलेंस, एंड एट दैट टाइम द पुलिस पेट्रोलिंग कार, द पुलिस पेट्रोलिंग वैन इज़ गोइंग ऑन पेट्रोलिंग. पेट्रोलिंग करती है, क्यों? वो ऑब्जर्व करती है कि दे आर रेगुलरली ऑब्जर्विंग द थिंग्स, दे आर कीपिंग वॉच ओवर एन पर्टिकुलर एरिया. ओके, सो सिमिलरली the patrolling car is also roaming through the area of zoo, and that's why tiger is able to listen to the patrolling car's sound. And apart from this activity of hearing the patrolling car's sound, he is observing the stars which are hanging in the sky with his brilliant eyes. Brilliant eyes means his eyes are shining during the night. You know that every animal's eyes getting shined during night. Okay, similarly his shining eyes are staring at the brilliant stars in the sky with the hope. Might be the hope is not mentioned ki kya purpose hai uske piche, ki why the tiger is staring the stars, brilliant stars, the purpose is not mentioned, but we can just guess that might be the tiger is thinking about how he will get free from this cage and how he will enjoy his previous life. That hope might be shining in his eyes. Here we can just guess. Okay, so in this way, students, the complete stanzas are getting over. Okay, so now along with stanzas, I have explained you the stanzas, but apart from them, I will also tell you the literary devices and as well as the rhyming scheme. Okay, first of all, the rhyming scheme we will see. You know students, rhyming words are the last words which are rhyming each other. Okay, so here stripe and cage does not match, that's why we will write here A, here cage, that means B, and quite is also not getting matched with the first and second, that's why it will be C. Now rage is getting matched with cage, and that's why the rhyming scheme will be B. So what is the rhyming scheme? A, B, C, B. Okay, so I told you the rhyming scheme A, B, C, B. Okay, so apart from rhyming scheme, This is the rhyming scheme which will be visible, which will be visible present in complete the stanzas, in entire stanzas. Only this rhyming scheme is available, A, B, C, B. Okay, now next one, we will see which literary devices has been used. Which literary device has been used? Number one, assonance. Assonance. Okay, so what is assonance? In assonance, the vowel sound is repeating or getting visible or present in the beginning or in the middle or in the end of the sentence. Assonance में वॉवल जो होते हैं, यू नो द वॉवल्स ए ई आई ओ यू, ये जो पांच वॉवल्स होते हैं, इसमें से अगर कोई भी वॉवल लाइन में बिगनिंग में आ रहा हो, मिडल में आ रहा हो या फिर एंड में आ रहा हो, तो वहाँ पे लिटरेरी डिवाइस एजोनेंस यूज होता है. हियर यू कैन सी आई साउंड यहाँ पे रिपीट हो रहा है, आई इन हिज आई, वी वीड में आई यूज हो रहा है, स्ट्राइप्स में भी आई यूज हो रहा है, तो आई साउंड इज प्रोमिनेंट. Okay, so I sound is prominent and I is vowel, and that's why this is literary device is assonance. Okay, so first literary device we have seen assonance. Second is imagery. Second is imagery. Imagery means the things which we can imagine, which we can imagine. Wait a second. Okay, fine. Next is imagery. So in this stanza, if you learn this stanza, if you understand the stanza, then a particular image will create in front of you, that there is a cage, in the cage the tiger is kept, the tiger is locked, and the tiger is having vivid stripes, bright stripes on his body, and he is only able to walk few steps in the cage, and that's why he is getting angry, but he could not display his anger, and that's why he is remaining quiet, he is remaining calm. So this imagery is standing in front of us, and that's why imagery device has been used. Okay, so here we can see we have seen that assonance, imagery, and next is personification. Okay, so next is personification. So personification, what means, what is personification? जिसमें किसी नॉन लिविंग थिंग को, एनिमल को, बर्ड को, ह्यूमन थिंग की क्वालिटी, ह्यूमन थिंग्स के, ह्यूमन थिंग्स की क्वालिटी दर्जा दिया जाता है. ठीक है, द नॉन लिविंग थिंग्स आर गिवन द ह्यूमन क्वालिटी इन पर्सोनिफिकेशन. नॉन लिविंग थिंग्स, बर्ड्स, एनिमल्स हैव बीन गिवन द क्वालिटी ऑफ ह्यूमन. ओके, सो हियर द फर्स्ट लाइन, ही, द वर्ड ही, actually he is referring to a particular human. जब भी he is a pronoun, okay, he क्या एक pronoun है जो हम human के लिए use करते हैं, particular boy के लिए use करते हैं. excuse me. And here, यहाँ पर जो he आया है, he is referred to the tiger. Okay, tiger को यहाँ पर personified किया गया है, that's why here personification has been used. Okay, so personification, assonance and imagery has been used in this stanza. Next one, in the next stanza we will see, in the second stanza the same imagery has been used. Imagery, that is a tiger is snarling around the houses near the jungle, which are the houses located at the jungle, border of the jungle. Now tiger is displaying his white fangs, white canines, his jaws, his claws, and the tiger is terrorizing the village. This imagery is also stand in front of us, that is imagery is there. Okay, so here imagery has been used
okay, because imagination, if we here we go through the lines, then a particular image create in front of us. That's why imagery literary device has been used here. Again, consonants has been used. Consonants, what is consonant? That is the in the consonant is a consonants is the consonant, you know that consonants, okay. Jab bhi kisi line mein consonant jo hai wo beginning mein, middle mein ya fir end mein aata hai, to wahan pe consonants literary device use hoti hai, theek hai. So in the first line we can see S sound is prominent, should, snarl, houses, okay. So here we can say that S sound is prominent and S is consonants, okay. And next thing, we can see I sound along with the consonants, assonance is also there. Assonance, where is assonance? The sound of I, he's, white, he's, okay. So here I sound is prominent, that's why assonance occurred in this stanza, okay. And along with he is there, that means personification, okay. He is there, that means personification. So personification, assonance, consonance is occurred in imagery, is occurred in the next stanza. Now third stanza. In the third stanza, you can see again imagery is there. How the imagery occurred in front of us, how we confront the image. See, the tiger is lurking in the shadow. The tiger should lurk in the shadow. He should slide through the long grass and he should go near the water pool where the plum used to come to drink water. And in this way, tiger should attack his prey. So this kind of imagery has been created by Norris in front of us. That's why we can say that imagery has been used. Here also, imagery has been used. Okay, next thing after imagery, same, he is there, that means personification, okay. Personification has been there. Next thing, here is alliteration. Alliteration has been used. What is alliteration? Alliteration is having the particular sound, maybe of vowel or consonant, but that sound must be in the two words, consecutive two words. Wo sound consecutive two words mein aana chahiye ya phir do se zyada words mein aana chahiye wo letter, wo sound, tabhi wo alliteration hota hai. Here in the last line we can see that P plum, P then pass, okay. So here it, यहाँ पे अगर हम प्लम का जो लास्ट लेटर है उसको काउंट नहीं करते और सिंगल पी को काउंट करते हैं और लास्ट पास में का जो पी है उसको काउंट कर, दैट मीन टू वर्ड्स कंसेक्यूटिव. सो इन द टू वर्ड्स पी साउंड इज प्रोमिनेंट एंड दैट्स व्हाई इट इज कॉल्ड एलिट्रेशन. ओके, सो हियर वी कैन सी एलिट्रेशन, इमेजरी एंड पर्सोनिफिकेशन एंड राइमिंग स्कीम विल बी द सेम, नो डाउट. Second last stanza, same, here his word has been used. His word has been used, that means personification is there because human quality has been given to the tiger, okay. So here personification has been used, same imagery, literary devices also used because we can imagine that the tiger is locked behind the bars and he is also himself locked his power, his ferocious nature behind the bars, okay. And he could not show his anger, he could not roar on the visitors, and that's why he himself ignored the visitors. How he is ignoring the visitors in the cage, we can imagine, that's why imagery has been used here. Next thing, we can see here alliteration, BB, behind bars, Okay, alliteration is here. Again in the same line we can see, again in the same line we can see that E sound in the first line, assonance is there. In the first line, assonance, because he E, logged E, concrete E, and sail E. Okay, so assonance means the vowel appeared in the beginning, middle, and end of the sentence. Okay, so vowel E is there, vowel E is appearing over there in the first line, that's why assonance literary device is occurring. Next, apart from assonance, imagery, personification, alliteration, I told you that behind the bars, B sound is prominent, B sound is prominent, okay, that's why here it is, alliteration also we find. In the last stanza, same imagery is there, and along with the imagery, there is he, that means it is personification, okay, he appears there, that's why it is personification. Next, it is imagery, we can imagine now, how we can imagine the tiger is listening to the patrolling cars, means patrolling cars are roaming through the area, and tiger is looking at the stars hanging in the sky. Okay, apart from that, we can see personification, imagery, and what we see? We can see the sound of S, hears, last, S, okay? So, but here the two times the S is occurred, and that is in the middle, in the end and the middle. So, here we cannot say that it is any literary devices. But in the third line, you can see that stairs, S is there. Again, in his, S is there. Again, in eyes, S is there. Okay, so that is here we can say that consonants. Okay, consonants, it is appeared in this stanza. An important one, metaphor has been used. Important one, metaphor has been used in the stanza, in the stanza one. What is metaphor? Metaphor in that in metaphor, two things are compared. As I told you, that velvet pads of velvet, pads kya hote, pads are the paws of the tiger, the feet of the tiger, which are very soft at the bottom, spongy. Okay, so that's why here the pads are compared to the softness of velvet, that's why metaphor has been used. So what is metaphor? Softness of tiger's paws is compared to the softness of velvet fabric, and this indirect comparison is called metaphor. So students, I have explained you the stanzas, the word meanings, and the literary devices along with the rhyming scheme. So thank you, and just watch the video, and if any doubt, then please reply. Thank you.